No. The magnitude of the reflection coefficient is constant, no matter what d is, because the distance from the center of the Smith chart to our impedance dot has not changed, even because we're rotating around the center of the Smith chart at a constant radius. So we can call this the circle of constant reflection coefficient magnitude. Now remember that earlier we showed the reflection coefficient at some distance from the load. This is the reflection coefficient, say, could be the voltage at position D, is the magnitude of the reflection coefficient, same voltage, e to the j theta r. This would be at the load, and some distance from the load, we do minus 2 beta d. This is the phase-shifted voltage reflection coefficient. We already accounted for theta r. We accounted for that when we plotted the reflection coefficient at the load, when we plotted this here. It was already at 51 degrees. So now we just need to rotate by minus 2 beta d. We rotate along a circle of constant reflection coefficient. It's constant radius from the center. So that's a circle of constant radius around the center of the Smith chart. Returning to our example, find both the magnitude and the phase of the input, the reflection coefficient, at position 0.18 meters from the load.